Hello, I welcome all the students for the lecture series of subject Theory of Computation. Today we'll start unit number 2, that is regular expressions. In the first unit we have seen finite state machine, whereas in unit number 2 we have to discuss what is regular expressions. So, very first question about regular expression is, what is regular expression? Regular expression can be defined as a language accepted by a finite automata. Now, we have seen in unit number 1, we have seen finite automata, we have seen what is finite automata, we have seen NFA, DFA, we have seen Millet machine, we have seen Murray machine. Now, the language accepted by the finite automata is represented in the form of simple expression, and that expression is called as the regular expression. So, here the first question, that is what is regular expression? The language accepted by finite automata, the language accepted by finite automata is represented by simple expression and it is that expression is called as regular expression. That regular expression is called as the special expression is called as the regular expression. Now, the language accepted by a finite automata is called as the formal language. The language accepted by the finite automata is called as the formal language. And that language we can represent, that language also we can represent in the form of a special expression, and that expression we can term as a regular expression. Now, what is the formal definition of regular expression? This is what the general definition we have seen. The language accepted by finite automata is represented by a simple expression, and that expression is called as the regular expression. That is the general definition. What is the formal definition of regular expression? So, we will see the formal definition of regular expression. So, the formal definition of regular expression, it can be defined as the class of regular expression. I'll use abbreviation RE, the class of regular expression over summation is defined as first point, regular expression over summation include letters, it include letters phi, that is empty set. Phi is used to represent the empty set, and theta, that is empty string of length 0, empty string of 0 length, that is the first point. Second point, it consists of every symbol, A belongs to summation. Summation is used to represent the alphabet. In unit number 1, we have seen in the basic concept, we have seen what is summation. summation is used to represent the alphabet. If every symbol A belongs to alphabet is a regular expression, is a regular expression, is a regular expression. Third point, if R1 and R2 are regular expressions, are regular expressions, then are regular expressions over summation, then we can say R1 plus R2, R1 dot R2 and R1 star is also a regular expression, is also a regular expression. If R1 and R2 are regular expression over summation alphabet, then R1 plus R2, R1 dot R2 and R1 star is also a regular expression where this plus indicates alteration. This plus indicates the alteration or parallel. This plus indicates alteration, or it is also called as parallel, whereas dot indicates concatenation and star indicate closure. Star indicates the closure property. So, if R1 and R2 are regular expressions, then we can have R1 plus R2, R1 dot R2 as well as R1 star, these are also regular expression. And the fourth property, last property, that is regular expressions are only those that are obtained using rule number 1, 2, 3. So, whatever these three rules are there, so whatever the regular expression we can obtain using rule number 1, 2 and 3, okay, so that particular expression we can term as a regular expression. So, as far as these rules are concerned, these three rules are concerned, so we can say regular expression over summation include letter phi, that is empty set. Empty set is also a regular expression, whereas theta, that is empty string of zero length, that is also a regular expression. Whereas we can say every symbol that belongs to summation, that means that belongs to alphabet, is also a regular expression. Whereas if R1 and R2, these are the regular expressions, then union, or we can say alteration or parallel path, or concatenation or closure, these are also the regular expressions. So, we will see in detail like how to represent the union or alteration or concatenation as well as the closure properties. So, that we will discuss in the next lecture. I will stop here. Thank you.